Hola, I'm MJ Marfori, and this is Celebrity Top 10. We give you the latest, the juiciest, and the hottest entertainment news, ba pa local man o international. Kinahatid namin sa inyo because here's a countdown. You shouldn't miss the new normal. You can't resist. What are we waiting for? Let's start with today's number 10. This has been getting rave reviews, but yeah, the official trailer of Pinocchio is out. Here it is. Pinocchio is back, guys. So Netflix released official trailer of Guillermo del Toro's stop-motion musical adaptation of the classic tale about a puppet who wishes to be a real boy. Geppetto is voiced by David Bradley, while Pinocchio is voiced by newcomer Gregory Mann. Joining them are Christoph Waltz, Kate Blanchett, Tilda Swinton, Ewan McGregor, and many more. Pinocchio will be released December in theaters and on Netflix.
I want to tell you a story. It's a story you may think you know, but you don't.
Over there! What is that?
Papa! It speaks!
He's just a puppet!
No, I'm not! I'm a real boy!
People are sometimes afraid of things they don't know.
I don't understand!
We have found him, our star.
Everyone shall love you and call your name Pinocchio.
Pinocchio!
I have something I'd like to give you. It is a school book which belonged to a very special boy.
The boy you lost? Papa!
Enough of this nonsense.
Tell him I love him. And I won't be a burden anymore. Hello?
The wooden boy with the borrowed soul. While you may have eternal life, your loved ones, they do not. You never know how long you have with someone until they're gone.
The boy loves you. For who you are.
Guide him to be good.
Stop that! Don't hurt him anymore!
You may have no strength, but I control you.
Please bring him back to me.
Life is such a wonderful gift.
Wow! It's time to give this OG some credit. So Snoop Dogg's biopic is set at Universal Pictures. Well, the question is, what will it be about? Will it be about weed? Oh my God. Anyway, Snoop Dogg's life story will soon be on the big screen. Production of his biopic is ongoing, and at this moment, it's still untitled and will be directed by Alan Hughes. Aside from a glimpse of his life, the movie will feature Snoop Dogg's music catalog. Really, about time. So what, we get drunk? So what, we're just having fun. In a statement release, Snoop Dogg said that he wanted to so long to put this project together because he wanted to choose the right director, but now it's happening. We're going to give you the updates on this project, but we're going to talk about this iconic figure. Okay, fine. Let's marvel on Jennifer Aniston's figure, beauty, etc. But really, what she did share in this article is how she did struggle to get pregnant. She opened up about her personal life in an intimate interview with Allure for its December story. And in that interview, Jennifer shared about her attempts to get pregnant via IVF, drinking Chinese teas, and many more. She was candid about it, but yes, it's a struggle women face. She said she had zero regrets about her efforts because she did all that she could. She's also thankful for those sad things that had happened in her life and made her she who she is meant to be. All right, John Wick drops its trailer. It's for their Chapter 4. Keanu Reeves is back in the hit franchise kasi niregaluhan niya yung staff niya ng mga Rolex. The trailer for the fourth installment is out and it shows John Wick discovering path to defeat the high table and face a new enemy, Marquis de Garmont. In the cast of the movie, it includes Lawrence Fishburne, Shamier Anderson, Hiroyuki Sanada, and many more, directed by Chad Stahelski. Guess what? Yes, Lawrence Fishburne. Is this a Matrix reunion of some sort? Anyway, it's set for release Lionsgate 2023, and with PLDD, they have a tie-up with Lionsgate, if you're interested about that. All right, Jason Momoa meets the love of his life. Huwag kayong mag-alala, guys. Kahit na single si Jason Momoa at naghubad, di ba, sa kay Jimmy Kimmel. After experiencing heartbreaks from former wife, well, nakahanap na siya ng bago. Pero hindi ito tao, don't worry. Isa itong baboy. I love it. Jason met the black pig, Apua, that during the filming of Slumberland. We talked to Jason, the other cast members, about the film, about acceptance and grief, and here's what they said.
I relate to Nemo because she's very close with her father, so if I ever lost my dad, I can only imagine the pain that I would go through. And so I think, especially playing her, seeing her go through all these stages of grief, and then just accepting it at the end, I think is really inspirational.
It's just it's a beautiful film, just watching and how we go into our dreamlike state or other things to cope with the pains that we're going through.
All right, we're halfway on the show. Hello to everyone watching us, listening to us live here at Celebrity Top 10. We're 4:45 p.m. on One News. Hello to Judy and Luna, Carlo Constantino, always watching and listening to us. To everybody, Lola Virgi, thank you so much. May mga ano tayo, no? Talagang seniors watching us, ano, always. Yes, thank you so much, guys. I love you. We do have replays on 1PH and Radio 592.3 News FM. But right now, let's talk about Disney Plus because it's launching next week. There are a lot of things to talk about in this. Disenchanted is the project we're going to talk about. And Disney Plus has released a delightful new trailer for Disenchanted. It's still a musical comedy sequel to Enchanted, the film which reunites original cast members Amy Adams, Patrick Dempsey, Idina Menzel, and James Marsden. It has been more than 10 years since Giselle, played by Amy Adams, and Robert, played by Patrick Dempsey, did wed. But Giselle has grown delusion in life in the city, or disillusion, rather. So they move their growing family to the sleepy suburban community of Monroeville in search of a fairy tale life. Unfortunately, it isn't the quick fix she had hoped for. And right now, after a day after it launches in the Philippines, Disenchanted will be a Disney Plus. The Super American Circus is performing in Manila. This Christmas, Filipino families can finally go out of their homes after 2 years of pandemic lockdown and be amazed at the world-famous Super American Circus coming in the Philippines. That's December 21, 2022 until January 8 of 2023 at the Newport Performing Arts Theater, Newport World Resorts in Pasay City. And we did talk to some of the acrobats. They're coming in December. We're going to give you exclusive access on the behind the scenes of the circus. Families will be in for a marvelous two-hour treat and what is dubbed as the biggest ensemble of live on one ring today. Namiss ko yan. Sobrang ganyang klaseng spectacles. Kailangan ng mga bata niyan. Papanoorin ko niyan si Erin. Sobrang galing nila, guys. They're coming here. Huwag natin palampasin yan, and it's perfect this holiday season. Filipino alt rock icons do a collab for a concert. Talagang mga ano to, no? Mga superstar, iconic OPM women, Barbie Almalbes, Aya De Leon, Aisel Visa, Hannah Romawack, Kitching Adele, and Luigi Basabas will be collaborating for a special number in their joint concert dubbed Tanao, happening November 26th at the Theater at Solaire, rocking the big stage with a vibrant and dynamic set list that cuts across multiple generations. The six iconic artists are set to showcase their hard-earned legacy in a space that has always been dominated by men. They are awesome. So here's what happened to the Eraserheads concert that's happening on December. Well, they're reopening ticket sale. More tickets are now available, guys, if you want to watch it at the Huling El Bimbo Eraserheads reunion concert. After producers expanded the capacity for each section and created an additional general admission section, the highly anticipated concert is set to happen December 22 at the SMDC Festival Grounds in Parañaque. But our question is, we need to know, of course, the safety measures they've been doing for this. But yeah, the fifth member, the late Francis Maglona, will be given a tribute by performing him on a stage through hologram. The Huling El Bimbo Eraserheads Reunion Concert 2022 will be the first reunion since 2009. Grabe, Ronnie Liang. Nagalit, okay, ang ating singaling-sing mask as Duke Boss. Dahil may nag-offer daw sa kanya gumawa ng porn. Kakaloka. Thanks, but no thanks. Or no thanks at all, Ronnie. Ronnie went viral after a lengthy post on social media where he directly said no to offers of doing porn movies. He said he got pissed and disappointed because he does so much, guys. Really. He further stressed that he is a Christian and that respect to self and his colleagues in and out of showbiz are vital to him. He was accompanied with a post of a topless photo with a caption, "Gandito na lang pwede ko ipakita." Ronnie's post received both positive and negative comments. Ronnie has yet to comment on this, but we're going to talk to him soon. And anyway, that's it for today. Ding, ding, ding. Guys, it's 44 days before Christmas. We're giving an appeal, okay, to still continue staying safe from COVID-19, guys. Get boosted. And that's it for today. Makalisa mga countdown Mondays to Fridays. I'll see you on Monday, 4:45 p.m. Juan News with replays at 1 p.m. Radio 592.3 News FM. I'm MJ Marfori. Thank you so much for joining me. This is Celebrity Top 10. My boy.